understood Bharata. Not single, but not one single person, huh? Understood his heart. He came out there, he saw the Ayodhya people were looking at him as if they would, no, as if he were an enemy. He didn't understand. They were shutting the doors on his face. But he didn't wait to look and find what it was. He had to go and find it, really know what the crux of the matter is. He went straight to the Ayodhya, inside the palace, and he always knew that Dashratha would be in Kaikeyi's chamber. So to see his father, he went to the court. He saw Darbar, no one was there. He went straight to Kaikeyi's chambers. He saw his mother, and you know, since the rites had not been performed, he didn't see any difference in her. The moment she saw Bharata, she smiled. She was so happy. She called him, she hugged him, said, "Bharata, you're back. I'm so happy. How are you? How is uncle doing? Is everybody fine there?" When he saw Kaikeyi like this, he was convinced that nothing was wrong. Because if something were wrong, Kaikeyi wouldn't be like this. That's what he thought. Power he assumed. When Kaikeyi Mata is so, you know, happy and asking about her brother and all and her father, nothing could be wrong. He said, "Ma, everyone is fine. Is everyone good here? Where is father? I didn't see him in the court. I don't see him here. Where is he?" Very naturally, huh? Why is Ayodhya like this? No, is everything fine? I want to talk to my father. Where is he? He asks this as a matter of fact. And the shock of our life is when we read this part of Ramayana. You know, Valmiki puts it so beautifully. Kaikeyi replies as a matter of fact. She says, "Ya gati sarva bhutanam tam gatim te pita gataha." Your father, he has attained that state which every mortal will have to attain someday. He is dead. That's it. Bharata fell down. Hard it seems. He couldn't take that. He said, "Amma." Even then he didn't figure out that how come Kaikeyi is, you know, so pleasant. How can she be smiling? He didn't think of that. He was too shocked with the news. He got up and he said, "How did that happen? How can someone like Dasharatha Maharaj die?" You know, he had always imagined him to be immortal. Someone who has been living for 60,000 years. You don't expect him to die. He has never sneezed in his life. He has never got fever in his life. He says, what came upon him? Was he ill? If he was ill, why was I not informed before? I could have at least seen him alive once. I have been away for so long. Why did he not tell him? Amma, tell me, how did he die? What happened? Please tell me. And Kaikeyi says, and Bharata asks, "Did he leave any message to me?" He says, "He did not even think of you. He did not even think of you. He cried, 'Ha Rama, Ha Lakshmana, Ha Rama.' And all he did was, you know, he shouted for Rama and he died.